Hi, I'm Vin Morreale. In this quick tutorial, we're going to look at how you customize your motion title presets that are available as part of the February 2018 Preset Pack. Now, the February 2018 Preset Pack contains 25 motion title presets, and this quick start guide will assist you in customizing the look of those presets. Now, this guide assumes that you have installed your presets into the Title Studio 3D Objects folder, and they are available for use in the FX browser. If you have questions on installing the presets to the correct directory, please refer to the installation guide for details on your specific operating system and host. Now, to begin customizing my presets, first I'm going to apply Title Studio to a clip and launch the FX browser. I'm going to select the preset I would like to customize. In this instance, I will select Cubed Blue. Now, the preset pack comes with 5 sample color variants for each preset, but you can modify them in any way you would like. Once I've selected Cubed Blue, I'm going to select the Advanced Mode button to launch the Title Studio user interface. Now, the first thing I notice is that the preset is broken down into 2 separate containers, Text to Edit and Cube. All presets available with Title Studio are organized to allow you quick access to modify the text as well as various elements of the preset. I'm going to begin by twirling open the Text to Edit container. When I click on the arrow to the left, it reveals 2 editable text tracks, Title Studio and Boris Effect. I'm going to select Title Studio to access the parameters to modify this track. Now, if I scrub through the timeline, I can see that there are keyframes animating the text position Y movement. If I click on the Show Hide Material track and select the Flat Texture track, I'm going to notice that the top parameter is set to 50. What this means is that my text is cropped so that it's only revealed when the position Y is moved. I can adjust the parameter to crop at a different point, but for now, I'm going to leave it the way the preset was originally designed. Generally speaking, I should not have to edit these parameters, but it's good to know how these effects are pieced together. To change my text, I'm going to select the Title Studio track, and then up here at the top, I'm going to select the Text Track tab. In the Text Generator window, I can edit all of the text, the color, the tracking, the styles, and even the fonts. Additionally, I can add drop shadow, I can add a stroke, or even a gradient. But be aware that changes to the length of text can alter the look of the preset. In some cases, I may need to adjust other parameters in the preset to fit the custom text in the template. Let's change the text here to Motion Presets. Now, you can feel free to modify the text style in any way that you want, but for right now, for this tutorial, this looks good. Next, I'm going to select the Boris Effects track and change the text to Title Studio. When I play the effect, my new text animates on and off in the exact same way that the default text originally did. Now, this is good, but what if I want to change the color of the cube? Well, the first thing I'm going to do is use the reveal triangle to close my text to edit container. And then I'm going to open up my cube container. Now, the first thing that I see is that this cube is actually made up of 2 rectangle tracks, top and bottom. When I look at the texture track, I can see that each are cropped about halfway. This allows me to control the top and bottom halves independently. It also allows me to design the effects so that the cube does not animate behind my text track. Now, if I select the material track of either the top or bottom cube, I'm going to notice that there is a keyframe animating the border end parameter. This allows me to control the speed at which the cube draws on. Now, the cube itself is actually just an edge border. If I go over to the Fill tab, I can see that it's disabled. By enabling fill, I can see that the interior of the cube now displays. By enabling the fill on both tracks, I can create an entirely new look. But for now, though, I'm going to leave fill off and go back to the border tab. To change the color of the boxes, all I need to do is make sure that the material track is selected and I'm in the border tab. I can then change the color by clicking the color chip, but I can also use the eyedropper or RGB fields to select a different color. Adjusting settings like edge width, opacity, softness, and even style will allow me to further customize the template. Now, in more complicated presets, for example, the blue spinning logo, the various color tracks have been labeled for easy identification. In each case, changing the border color will update the preset. It's worth noting that when adjusting text, it may be necessary in some cases to adjust cropping to get the results needed. If the text is longer than the preset, all I have to do is simply select the flat texture track and go to Crop Output. Depending upon how long my text is, I may need to add keyframes to animate the crop. Feel free to experiment by changing different parameters and adjusting the preset to your liking. And that's all there is to it. I'm Vin Morreale with Boris Effects, and for more great tutorials, don't forget to check out the Boris Effects website. Take care.